Kun Sanpakit Jamnong from Gasesat University Educational Technology Department. I'm in charge of a chairperson today. Before we start our session, some announcement. Anybody forget your glasses in the main hall? You can get your glasses back at the customer service in front of this room. You are? Really? Yeah, just a, yeah, the red sign in front of this room, customer service. And pay them about 20,000 baht. Yes, for service charge. US dollar. Okay. So just in front. Yeah, right in front. The red sign. The red sign. Mm-hmm. And in this room, we're going to have the workshop about, we read it MERLOT, right? The pronunciation, same as the name of the wine. Anybody wine lover? The wine that we drink, MERLOT wine, same pronunciation, not MERLOT. We always, Thai will read like MERLOT, but it's MERLOT. Yeah, yeah. So don't get drunk when we stop our workshop. Yeah, it will be fun. And I just know from Professor Gerry that if you don't have the PC, don't worry. They can use the tablet, yeah, mobile phone. What about the very early mobile phone? Cannot. Or a smartphone, okay. Anybody use that? Hero or something? We have the name of the mobile phone, very outdated. Is that yours? No? Okay, okay. Yeah, we have password. One moment, I will ask the staff to give you the password. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, get back to the formal. No, this different. This different. This is for you, VIP. The workshop will start from now until 16:30, and between that, we will have some coffee break. The staff will show you the sign, times out at 15, okay? And it will be continue until 16:30, okay? I think all of you attend the morning session, right? You already know Professor Gerry already. So please welcome Professor Gerry.
Is that why you're here? And what I'd like to do, remember there was one of the sayings I had is, teach people, not information. Right? And so what we're going to begin with is, you're the people who I'm here to help you learn about MERLOT. So I need to know just a little bit about what you want to learn. Right? Because each of you has somewhat different, some of you might be faculty members, some of you might be students, some of you might be IT staff, some of you might be administrators. You all have a little different kind of purpose. So what I'd like to do, and we can do it pretty quickly, just to let them know what's something that you would like to learn today, or that you're curious about, or a question you have, or something I might have said in the talk that you want to know more about. Just a little hint about what would be important to you. So let me start off with you. If you don't mind, I'll move on. I'll let you know,
everything about MERLOT, I'd like to know the difference between MERLOT and other tools out there, other popular tools out there. What are the main features compared to things such as MBS or MERLOT?
Great.
My name is David. I'm at Stanford University now. I worked at Chula Longhorn for 12 years. I've been in Thailand. He sits on BP Lounge. And I helped bring Webster University in Thailand to Thailand back in the 90s. Now I've been teaching online for 14 years at the University of Maryland, and kind of interested in more than computer content-based materials to see what is applicable, what creates a lot more interchange and dialogue between students and teachers, gets students hooked into each other so that they can bring more to the table from say, using the site.
Great. Excellent. And this is David's point of how do you empower the students with their learning to help them find materials that's relevant for them and bring into the classroom instead of having just one faculty member who's doing all the work. If you have a class of 30 students who are curious about stuff, who can be out there find stuff, then you have 30 people bringing in and can really enrich the classroom, and MERLOT could be a tool that could help that engagement process.
My name is
Peter.
I'm from here.
Simulations, animations, collections. So, and it's not more like a learning management system, Blackboard, Moodle, etc. So think of it as a library that you can plug in and use within your learning management system. Now, on the research side, your students might have trouble with statistics if they're doing their master's thesis, something like that. Well, MERLOT could be a place where someone could get a lot of help with tutorials on how to do statistics. And so you can help the research, the students doing research, with helping them get tools to help them do the statistics better. So just one example. Brought back and now given access to students. And the answer of all this is yes. You can give them MERLOT.org and they can be ready to go. And you can actually translate this into Thai if you want to, using Google Translator. That might make it a little easier to use as well.
My name is
Kudala Sauler.
I'm from Thailand.
And is something you want to learn? For your students? Okay, great.
My name is Kipo. My nickname is Kit. I'm a part-time teacher at Chancellor University. I really like MERLOT, and I find that your presentation is very interesting and helpful. But the reason I come here is because I follow the word evaluating your own teaching.
Yeah, that's why I came here.
Many times I find out that people just teach and never see how much students learn from that teaching. So it's very interesting to be very important.
And this is something what MERLOT, we often think maybe it's you say it's just for the instructor, but a lot of it is for the students, right? And if you give them a learning activity, a student can put their comments into MERLOT about how they use that material that you chose for them, and then they can give you feedback about how did this help them learn. And just I can show you examples. Because students, when we look at all the members in MERLOT, we have over 140,000. About 40% of the people who are members in MERLOT are students. 50% are faculty. so it really is a student tool, and getting their comments really helps you evaluate, oh, is this good for them? Because often we just assign them things that we often never know would have really helped them learn, because we never give them an opportunity to give you feedback in two ways. That's right.
In learner differences. So with this tool, different learners can seek for the information they want to study. And I also believe in self-directed learning. And I also want to combine e-learning with my class and study outside classroom, things like that. So, yeah.
Good. Right. And apart, you know, libraries have always been a place for self-directed learning. You've all had, you know, in your education, right? At some point you're going to the library because you have a question that you want answered. And you direct yourself. And in a sense, this is just an open public library for learning materials. So a lot of things, kind of the innovative aspect of things is having the sense in a metaphor of what MERLOT is, because people say, what's MERLOT? But think of it like a library of teaching and learning materials. That's free for you. It's a public one. You walk in, you can use stuff, you walk out, no one asks you to pay for anything. Well, thank you.
We are from the university. I want to know about the model how people work in the university. Would that be on the student on the learner on the
okay. How to enhance the learning, because sometimes a teacher talking all the time can be pretty boring, right? So how can you give them tools where they can work on their own and really become self-directed learning helps actually motivate the learner because they start choosing what's good for them and what interests them, and that's why it can be very powerful to have that work. So. All right, I'll make sure we talk about that too. I'll show you some things. And have you start playing too.
Hello, my name is Hanley. I'm from Washington University. I'm technology education.
Now, do you help people design online courses? And is it kind of a headache sometimes? And this is something where you can find what's already been done, and so you can, in a sense, borrow it, so you don't have to recreate it, and it can help you. That's a good one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Sometimes, right? A lot of this. Well. You know, and as a teacher, sometimes, you know, there are some times where you just have just so much to do. So how do you, in a sense, get rid of some of these burdens? And MERLOT, sometimes you need to drink a little wine, but we'll try to get rid of it. We won't have wine today.
Don't tell her to drink.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Waiting for my signature.
Oh.
To graduate.
Oh. Okay.
This is why he is here. Tomorrow is the last day to submit the report.
Oh. So why are you here? You should be doing your report. Is your report all done?
Here.
Oh, it's right there.
Sorry.
Oh.
Sorry about that.
So maybe we can help him.
Oh, listen, we should definitely have wine for
congratulations.
Well, congratulations. Yeah. And so you're looking at the next person?
I will not tell you my last name because it's about a tail long.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. And I'm from Northeastern University in Bangkok. In Phuket.
Okay.
Yeah. And what I'm interested in is, I look at your topic, I'm interested present in every single word that you know you have here, especially in terms of building and evaluating, and especially your own teaching and learning philosophy. I have a lot of questions, but maybe I will ask why you are writing. I think that's what that would be
good.
Especially in terms of. I have looked, you know, at your website, and then I tested by the, you know, putting the keyword, you know, in order to look for the text, and then you know, I was able to look at the text. But the problem is, you know, Thai students, to be honest, Thai students, they don't work as hard as your students, okay, and especially in terms of, you know, curiosity, you know, if they got this word, then we will be very happy. The problem is they don't have even the word curiosity. So I wonder, you know, how this program, how this method will be able to enhance their learning and then, you know, especially, you know, make them, you know, have more engagement in really, you know, self-validating.
And if I can solve that problem in 3 hours, that'd be great, right?
Yeah, even the whole day, I'm quite happy to be with you. Okay. Thank you.
My name is Dion. I'm from Asian Institute of Technology, and one of my job is providing the security tools for IT tools to the customers. And I was supposed to take another workshop, but I changed my mind because there's no security in the classroom. And then I want to explore the model to how to make the model is to define the better people to have each
program. So, and actually there's we have things in MERLOT about learning about how to teach with different methodologies. So we have something called pedagogy. So all the different strategies, right? So quickly I can show that. Okay. Now the first thing, and if you don't have tablet or laptop or anything, squeeze next to a partner and then you can watch what they're doing. All right. Now, I'm going to start off with showing you how to browse at the library. You like to go into a bookstore?
Yeah.
And you just kind of walk around and kind of see what's there, right? This is, a lot of people just put in a keyword and search. But browsing is just, it helps you explore things. You find serendipitously some interesting stuff. So the way you get into MERLOT, if you want to search through it, you can click down to see that orange, that triangle, right? You can click that and you can say, I want to browse all the materials. See where it says browse the materials? So you click on that.
So just click on that.
And the network's a little slow here, so you just have to be patient. Now, what this is going to do, as we're reading here, to a regular library, a bookstore, it's organized by topic areas, right? So over here are all the topic areas that you can find in MERLOT. So let's start off with physics, right? I'll just, so we can get that started right there. Then I'll show you business, okay? And we'll approach it right there. So I say, oh, I'm interested in physics. That's in that's the floor in my library, science and technology. So I can click on that, and as you notice here, there's 38,000 materials in science and technology. And so notice that I clicked on science and technology, and just note here, it's called the breadcrumb, so I know I'm in the science and technology area. And then here are all the subtopic areas, and I could be, and you can see there's engineering, geoscience, health sciences, right? And so here we have physics. Okay. Now, in the people who are instructional designers who work on developing courses, this is where you can say, what course am I teaching? Go to those topic areas. So let's go physics. Okay, and here's all the kind of general topic areas, classical mechanics, and a lot of introduction in physics is around in classical mechanics, for example, thermodynamics, stuff along those lines. Now as we are browsing through the library, on this side over here, these are all kind of the materials. Right? And so when you browse in the library, you go to a floor, science and technology. And then you go down the aisle of physics. And now we're going to go down the shelf of classical mechanics. So that's the metaphor you can think about. And then you see different stuff on the shelves. So when we go something like here, we can then... So now, if we're in the area of physics, what you see in like any search, here's the name of the material. Now, MERLOT provides you a description of it. This is a website that has been evaluated by experts in the field, right? So these are physics faculty who said, this is a good website. There are people who've rated it, just users, students, faculty, just on their own. People have written comments around it. There are things called bookmark collections. So what you can do in MERLOT, did you have a bookmark on your browser? Do you ever remember what all those bookmarks are for? You forget those? Well, you can create, in a sense, little bookshelves for yourself in MERLOT. I'll show you about it. Then you can make a more complicated course of your code. So let's just go here. So I'm down in the physics side. So I click on the title, and then this gives you a description of what it is, and here's more of the reviews and more information about it. Here's who is it for, any technical information. It has English. And here's something. Anybody know what this is right here? Creative Commons. This is a way that of telling you, do you have permission to use this any way you want? And if you have a CC BY, this Creative Commons, you don't have to worry about someone coming after you and suing you, right? You can use this, you can stick it in your course, you can pull it apart, you can do whatever you want with those materials. Okay? So CC BY is really telling you, go have fun, go use it. And here's some other, at the bottom here, here's people who've made some comments, they like it, really good stuff. Suite of applications are phenomenal, right? So one of the issues around quality is, do colleagues kind of make some comments about these things? Now, right? So now let's go see the way to do it is, you just click on go to material. So now in our method, our kind of metaphor here, this is a library catalog, and now we're going to pull the book off the shelf, right? We're going to go see that, and so here is now the website. And it has all different types. And that actually, let me just show you this one. So here are all types of simulations in physics. You know, energy scheme.
Excuse me, do you have to reduce them? Because they've got a box. I'm just saying that teachers are just. Do we have to register?
Do we have to
register?
Register? No,
yeah.
No.
Yeah, they've got a box saying that teachers register now.
Yeah. Well, they're encouraging you to register so they have your contact. But none of this stuff you don't have to register, right? Like I didn't register here, right? And so. So if you want to use an embed code, there's this whole thing. And so something like this, let's just see. Someone skateboarding and they monitor kinetic and potential energy, right? And so you can modify kind of how you can take these points and move them around and then watch how the kinetic and potential energy changes, right? So that's one example. Let me just go through some other ones. This is just taking a long time to download. So were you able to see how we navigated to get to physics, and then there's a whole range of material? And that was just one website fed. There are literally hundreds of websites in the different topic areas. So that the easiest way to find instructional content, I find, is just browsing by your topic. Thank you. So we're back here. Now let's just do what I'd like all you folks to do down here is let's now go browse business. There's 6,700 materials. So this is the self-directed learning folks in lifelong development, lifelong learning. So someone might say, oh, I want to become a manager. I started out at one level and now I may want to learn more in management. So I click on management. And here's material. Again, here are peer reviews, user ratings. I said, oh, let me check out this one, the camera and Google factor. Is this helpful, folks, as I'm walking through this? Is this what you're looking for? Can you give me this? Be honest. Is this helpful walking through? Yes? So here's a camera gloom factory. Look to the sky, camera. And so what this is, it's a simulation on how to build balloons. And it gives people case studies. Build things. So if you're learning about manufacturing and you've never known about how to manage a whole manufacturing process, it gives you information, articles, etc. Right. You may say, you know what, I really don't like that. You can go back to the website and say, you know what, oh, maybe I'm looking for something that's more in project management. So you can see how you can just navigate back and forth to find materials. Basic things of browsing through the collection. Right? It should be relatively straightforward, okay? Yes, sure.
Learning exercise, is an opportunity to exercise creativity and executive design. And also one question, do we have to register our client to listen? Well, we just click and listen.
Once I show you what you can do with MERLOT, then we'll walk through about register. We'll get everyone registered if you want to register today. And we'll do that before we have a break. So make sure we do that. See, what I want to do right now is first show you, well, why would I want to register in MERLOT, right? What are some of the benefits of the tour? Right, so I've kind of taken the tour, so this is the selling part to say, is this something that's really valuable for you? Right?
There is nothing, I registered. But I have not got the message whether my registration has been accepted or not. I have not got any feedback like that.
Well,
you were later, so I.
Oh, you registered?
So I tried, yeah, and then I registered, but. There was no more feedback. So I'm not sure whether I have been accepted as one of the members.
We'll find out. We can search for your name.
Okay,
we can
see please, thank you.
Okay. All right. Let me show you something here, too, about what you can do in the world. here's something called bookmark collections. So what people do in Merlot is they say, oh, I found some, you know, here was this this material, Guide to Financial Statements. And what people can do is they can say, oh, you know what? I don't want to forget this one. I want to kind of put it on a little shelf for me, and so create what we call bookmark collections. And in this case, we have 74 people have found this material and they kind of bookmarked it for themselves. So the first thing is, if 74 people like it, it probably says this might be pretty good material. So again, it's a quality indicator. And then one of the things you can do is you can say, a lot of people have put this as accounting. Here's someone who says, my interests, stuff I would use in my personal life. Can you see how you put this little comment? So people are creating these different things, accounting resources, financial statements. And let me just pick one here that has principles of finance.
Do you mind going back to
the
original one
and
can you show us how to do
the bookmark? Okay, so here is the Guide to Financial Statements. And so you can click on the title. And then that brings up kind of the detailed description of it. And then over here, here's the bookmark collection. So you click on that. And then here it brings up the list of everyone's bookmark collections. And you can say, oh, let me look at this one. So this one, there's three materials in it. So here are three materials related to finance. And you say, well, who, you want to see who created that? So they're a faculty member. They're in Texas. And they joined in 2014, and they just did this a week ago. Was that helpful to see those things? And in part, this is the person's member profile. And they have one bookmark collection. So in Merlot, there's a library of materials, but there's also a library of people. And what's valuable about this is Perini has already found materials all related to the principles of finance. And then you can say, well, why do I have to go look for other ones? Can I just use hers, right? Now, if you remember in my talk, I said there's little icons about copying and all that other stuff. Because I am not registered in Merlot right now, I could just go and kind of window shop, and I can explore and click on, and I can use and all that other stuff. But when I want to create my own things, that's when I have to register for Merlot. Okay. So, and one of the reasons why we do that is if, let's see, to ensure good behavior on the internet. Because if it's anonymous, people may not behave as well as they should. But if it's always tied to their identity, and I've been doing this for 20 years, okay, I can tell you on the number of fingers and toes over 20 years, how many problems we have. Very, very few, and we have millions of people in this world. And a lot of it is because your identity as an educator or as a student is connected with what you're doing. And this was a gamble when we started this way back. but we realize your identity is very important. And so that's, because it's free and open for anyone, anywhere to use. So what's going to keep them doing, you know, respectful behavior? And so, so that's turned out to be a pretty effective mechanism. Do you folks feel that you have a pretty good idea just about how the structure of the library, how it works, the materials? Just want to get some, at least look at my eyes and say yes.
Can we walk through one more, let's pick another area at this point, just walk through one more.
You bet, no problem. So David, what?
Humanities.
Humanities, sure. Great, let's go through your hands. Okay, so let's go through, let's go home, we'll start from the very beginning. Home page, right, always good. And again, you can browse all the materials. No, I'm just showing you, taking the walk the same way each time. But you, like, there's a search box, and then there's all the stuff. So then, here's humanities. So here are the topic areas in humanities. History, English. Oh, how about world languages?
English.
All right. How about English as a second language? Would you like that? That type of stuff? English as a second language? So that's in world languages. And so here it is, ESL, English as foreign language, 631 materials. So here are, do you want things around teaching resources for English as a second language? Is everyone following along so far? So guide to grammar and writing, listening lab, TESOL journal, lesson plans for ESL, many interesting things for ESL students, writing den, computers and other languages, for computers in English for speakers of other languages. All right. So there's a whole set. Now, let me just show you some other things that we have here. There are many types of materials here. Right, let me just show you what I mean by that. So here are animations, or there might be collections of materials, or drill and practice, or there might be a whole online course, or simulations, reference materials, tutorials.
What's the number next to the title? They're like online course two. Does that mean there's two collections?
There's two online courses.
Okay.
Right, exactly. Thanks, David. So there's three workshops. There's 16 reference materials, 6 tutorials. So you might want to say, I'm interested in drill and practice. Right, something along those lines. So what I can do is I can click on that, and now what will happen, you'll get the list of 7 teacher resources that are only drill and practice. And so I can say, oh, maybe I'll look at Randall's, let's just see, Randall's ESL Cyber Listening Lab. It's been peer-reviewed. Should we take a look at what the peer review is saying, just so you get a sense of that? So a library of listening materials for ESL, a range of levels. They have strengths for quality of its content. Divided by proficient materials are divided into general survival skills and academic subjects. So it's giving you just some background about this material that's been used by other people and evaluated by experts in the field. Okay, was that helpful? Just to see what those peer reviews are?
Yeah, we went back to the last page and we see that group. Yeah. Is that one getting reviewed? I see where it says peer review. Does that mean five star?
Yeah, that's five star.
It's a five star rating.
Right. Okay. So that says, that this is pretty good. The users like it. It's in 31 bookmark collections, right? So you might say, let's just take a peek, just get a little practice at this. Yes. Right. So this is where kind of how do you get your students, right? Your students can register for free members of MERLOT, and they can give you feedback. Because, some people might like the ESL Cyber Learning Lab. Some people might like the interactive learning lessons. So getting to your point of self-directed learning, if you give people choices, have them go explore which ones they like most, and then they can put a comment around it, or they can create their own bookmark collection. And I'll show you how to do that. Say, here is my learning resources that I like. Okay. So let's just go to the bookmark collections again, so you can click on bookmark collections. And so here's one where someone has seven things. They have seven materials in their book collection focused on helping English language students. So I can click on that. And so here are seven materials related to ESL. Right? So think of this as someone has already done some work for you. You may want to say, well, maybe I can just copy those over and use those. So was that helpful showing you again, exploring the library, finding materials? Right. Now, again, we've just been window shopping.
So, can I mention one thing?
Sure, of course.
It's mostly just because my infatuation, I guess, creating the desire to have that. For example, there's like seven different names came up, right? And one thing catches my eye is ESL Blues. That's a good title. I don't know what's in there, I'm not going to pick it up. There's some boring ones, but not so exciting. But just giving it a nice headache, it's something to get it. Seems like to me to have a little bit of power to create a little more interaction.
And you know what you can do? When you take this list, you can rename these things. You can put your own description around it. You can personalize your collection of materials.
You can really send an email to the original writer saying, thank you, but I'm now called for this.
Well, and that's, and you can find, like you can find out who the author is, because all that information is here. So now, so far, folks, has this been helpful? I'm trying to making sure. Are you learning things a little bit? I forgot your name, right? You, the instructional design person who has headaches. And it's harder to use on your it's harder to use on your phone there, or you can do it on your phone? Get involved with it, you click on it. If you don't want to do it, You live in black?
Yes, I do.
And so, you know, how does MERLOT work? It's really volunteers around the world putting stuff together. Some people want to do, get involved. You actually, if you check that, we send you a letter saying, here is the training we would provide you so you can become a reliable peer reviewer. It's just not anybody can do it because evaluating online materials requires a certain methodology. And then, able to move forward on it?
Oh, you want to be able to get it.
Yeah. Yeah, well, maybe up to 20. It looks like a big reason to see. At that point, and we were building learning objects. That's what apps were called 20 years ago, learning objects. And what was happening is, people were building very similar learning objects. So we said, we need to build a library so that when someone builds something, they would stick it in the library, and before you start building something new, you should check, did someone already do it already, right? So it was just meant as an efficiency strategy for the CSU. And then what happened was other universities said, this is really neat. Can we join your library? And so Georgia, who else? Georgia, North Carolina, and Oklahoma states said, we'll also put stuff into the library. And then we said, well, that's a good idea. And then we said, well, let's just open it to everyone and let everyone put stuff back in the library. And so we built the technical infrastructure and we maintain it. And you say, well, why are we doing this? Well, there's 70,000 materials in MERLOT. And the amount that our faculty put in might be just a few hundred. So the library could not have been built without the world contributing. And now, everyone in California benefits from all the work that everyone does, right? So it's actually, it costs around, depending upon how you want to cut it, about $1 million a year to run MERLOT.
Well, the server cost and
staff. I have two programmers, a technical manager, a webmaster, few other people,
wow.
And that's it.
Ooh. Are you hosting it on site or in the cloud?
Right now, we're in some virtual machines on site. We're all going to move to the cloud, get to Amazon at some point. Oh, the business model is going to be a little better.
Yeah,
The benefit for us?
Yeah.
Huge, right? As I said, all the material that's in MERLOT, most of it has been created and contributed by other people. So if I had to pay librarians to build the collection, that would be $2 million a year. you know, the amount, you know, it would just be a whole lot extra, and it wouldn't be anywhere near as good as having everyone say this is what it's real users saying, here's what's useful in teaching and learning. Mm-hmm. Yes. And, you know, I've gotten grant funding and all that other stuff, but most of it is paid by us. When there are institutions who want to use it, and maybe I'll show you something here. Institutions who want to use LILO as a strategy. Let me just do this.
Awesome.
Great. I'll show you something, and then we'll take the break here. If you don't mind. So this is, I showed you this today, the Cool for Ed library. So here is, I can go to my courses. And if you remember, this is where I said the financial accounting, right? And so here are all the other courses there, biology, business, child development, chemistry, right? Okay. Now, I'll look at this. So this is another university in the United States called Excelsior College. And tell me if you notice anything that looks familiar. It's basically the same website, right? But it's branded, purple color, Excelsior College. It's unique to them, right? And so what I do, the way MERLOT makes a little money, is I charge Excelsior College $10,000 a year to deliver their own customized website. Right. They could never do that for $10,000, right? But for me, I just create an image of it, change a little colors, a few pictures, and now they'll be able to build on their materials on their own. And so how this works is,
and how the materials would be to your
back to MERLOT, and everyone else benefits from it. So that's how all this works, is everyone contributes just a little bit. Mm-hmm. And then
we make it all money.
And then
education.
Right. And here is, right. If everyone just did one thing in this room, there'd be an extra 20 materials. That's why if everyone just does a little bit, but you have to add it up, aggregate it, then you have the strength of what the MERLOT provides.
Excuse me, Gerry. Hey, this is only the course that we put into this thing, right? But because I used to do the e-learning courses from University of Oregon, I need to pay because it's for free also, but then there are faculty members to help us interactive, to make comments and then put it together. So at your program, no faculty members to do interactive teaching, right?
No.
Just listen to the talk.
Well, this, right? For this one, these are just books. These are just ebooks.
Oh.
So you just read these, right?
Yes, I understand. Sorry, I think that like you can look at the video people teaching by MIT. I mean, this is just only textbook for all I misunderstood.
Yes, sorry. Right. So for this website, let me just go back. For this website, it's just focused on textbooks. Now, MERLOT has video, it has online. That's all free too. People have many different interests and needs, right? And so we created this one just for faculty to lower the cost of education for students.
Right? They don't need to buy textbooks.
They don't have to buy textbooks. And so how do we solve that very simple problem to make it easy to find, where do I find free textbooks? Right? Because MERLOT has tons of stuff in it, right? But for a fact, you know, when you're looking for things, you want very few things.
Yeah.
Give me a choice of 3 or 4. Don't give me 500.
That's right.
Right? So that's why this website, again, Cool for Ed is a MERLOT website underneath it. But it's really just said, here's how I find textbooks, and here's faculty teaching the textbooks to keep it simple and straightforward.
And the textbook made by the faculty there, is textbook in the market?
Correct. They're free textbooks created by faculty around the world. Some of them by OpenStax, which is a group in the United States that got grant funded, and those are pretty good books, right? But we have over 4,600 free textbooks in MERLOT. But again, coming back to your purpose, what are you trying to do? If I'm trying to save students money with OER, what's costing them money are the textbooks. So then you just have a website that's just focused on textbooks. If I'm looking for mobile apps, right, because I want to do mobile learning, let me show you this.
And I also have another question. Because you said each of us can read something like text for the textbook. Like, does anyone do whether it's up to standard or not? I mean, if I'm doing something and send to you as what you have textbook, do they have like someone to make a review or think this is up to standard or not?
Right. And so here in the textbook one, right, this is where what we did is we have people who did the reviews of the textbooks, right? So again, when we're in textbooks, you have faculty review the textbooks, right? So you have, you know, reviews, and then the other thing here, we have how have faculty used them in the courses, right? So here's, let's just take a little while. So here are people who used economics. Let me just pull up one toward the end here. So we have a lot of these in physics, right? So here are physics teachers at University of California. I think they're at Berkeley. Mm-hmm. Here's Cal State, right? And then how are they using these free textbooks?
So this is a picture of a person who used it, right? Not the author.
Not the author. These are faculty members who use these.
Right.
And so here is Monco. He teaches physics. Here's the book he's using. Here's the course that he teaches. And then here is here's, you know, students can download the book for free, they get the PDF. They can also get it on iTunes. Students like the fact that books are inexpensive. They don't have to carry them around, blah, blah, blah. And he's, a full professor at Cal State University, Long Beach. So again, what this is doing is if you're trying to help save students money, how do you get faculty to change from using a Pearson textbook or a McGraw-Hill textbook to an open textbook? You often need to say, has anyone else done it? And so that's why these e-portfolios, the stories by faculty, become important. And just sort of these things, these e-portfolios that they created here. This is done in a MERLOT authoring tool, so it's free for you to do. So you can do these things too, and I can show you that if you want. A free authoring tool to do e-portfolios and something. Let's take a break.
Yeah. And have you ever, like, you know, kept the record of the frequency of each book used? You know what I mean? For
yes.
example, like that, yeah.
Yeah. And so what we know is how many people go look at the book.
Yeah.
But we don't know how many people have adopted the book because they do that outside of the law. So that's... In California, I'm tracking that because I can do that, but I can't do what the world is doing. And we are saving $30 million a year by moving off of expensive textbooks. Okay? Okay. Take a break. If you want to come back, we can. I can show you more things.